fine dining is, for me, subjective. I believe in the story that you tell, because then you get to learn a bit more about a people. I've been working in the industry for almost 10 years. From a young age, I used to go into the kitchen and help out with all the aunties at these functions. Could you get me some chapati? Could you get me some mandazi? Helping them out in the kitchen, my mum, my aunties, is what stemmed me onto like having that strong interest into food. This dish is groundnut sauce with malakwan. Malakwan is hibiscus, it's a green hibiscus, but it's hard to find green hibiscus in this country, so I've substituted that for the Cavolo Nero. After going to culinary school, I worked in restaurants. I did a few agency work as well, worked at a Three Michelin Star restaurant, doing an internship there. And from there, I wanted to basically open my own restaurant. The sauce is basically the groundnut sauce with the Cavolo Nero in there. I've watered off some Cavolo Nero here with a bit of matoke. Matoke is a East African Highland banana. And you can find it in Kenya, Tanzania, that whole region. And then the groundnut sauce is Ugandan. Actually, my mum brought that back with her when she visited last. So.
I think the fine dining comes from the storytelling, from actually putting some research into the dishes that I'm making, the tribe of the people, who they are, where they come from. This is what they used to eat here. This is what you're eating now. Ugandan cuisine is heavily influenced by a lot of Indian, Arabic ingredients. But you'd find even in traditional classical recipes that you might find in the book that we have to study, Escoffier, they use ingredients that are not exactly foreign to what we might use back in Uganda. Fine dining is not as diverse as it could be, but the future of fine dining is definitely changing. And I believe it's important for chefs from like ethnic backgrounds to stand up and try to represent who they are through their cooking.